Hey everyone, the Motivational Professor here. And in today's video tutorial, I'm going to show you how you can trade paper money or fake money so you can practice directly on TradingView. I'm going to show you this little secret area right in here where you can begin to paper trade for free on TradingView so that way you can practice right on this platform. So stay tuned and let's get into the video. Okay, so once you are on any TradingView chart, you can head down here to the bottom and you're going to see this tab called Trading Panel. Now, when you click on it, for example, it'll pop up like this. Or, for example, if it was minimized, you can also grab the top of your chart and you can scroll up with your mouse and it'll also bring up the exact same features. So for this case, I'm just going to go ahead and close this again just to show you that if you click on Trading Panel, it is going to open it up and then you'll see your chart up here. But this is the more important part. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and kind of slide this up, or you can click the tab in the upper right-hand corner here where it says Maximize Panel. And what that does is that solely brings up all of the different brokers that are available. Now, as you can see here on the board, all of these are brokers that work directly with TradingView. So you might be a TradeStation account holder or Oanda or Forex.com. You would be able to connect your live accounts or even your demo accounts within those brokers directly on TradingView. Most people don't have those forms of accounts. So I want to show you another way that you can trade for free. You can practice using TradingView. So what you would do is you would go ahead and click this paper trading tab right here, and then you would eventually connect your account. Now, paper trading is not just for new traders. It's even and should be used with experienced traders. I myself even have a paper trading account and also a demo account in my broker because, again, when I want to switch from a live account to a demo account for whatever reason, to practice a strategy, to backtest, my account is already created. So I want you to have your own paper trading account or demo account or fake money account right inside of TradingView, since that's the platform that we use to chart our analysis. Okay, so now that you are here on this screen, what you want to do is you want to head over to the TradingView paper trading tab that says right here, and you're going to see a little box that says to connect. What I want you to do is go ahead and click on connect. When you connect, you are going to get a confirmation screen like this that TradingView is telling you that paper trading is also known as simulated trading, and it lets you practice both buying and selling of securities. At this point, what you want to do is you want to go ahead and click on the connect button. Once you click on the connect button, you are going to see that it's going to take you to this tab here. You can see my account is set up up here, and you are going to get a walkthrough, if you want, of how the window looks and where you can find all of the orders and positions and history that you have done. If you notice over here to the right, you are going to see that they are going to start you with a pretty hefty account balance, and that is also the equity that you have in this paper trading account. Now, I think this is very important because this could also work as your trading journal. And again, if you are a brand new trader or less time trading, you definitely want to take advantage of having an account like a paper trade account, because it lets you practice, practice, practice. And again, I'm going to be showing you here in just a minute how to actually enter a buy or a sell position using the paper trade account inside of TradingView. Okay, so now that we've gone through the back end, the last thing you want to do is you want to go up here to the upper right-hand corner, and you want to go ahead and hide this panel. Okay, so now I'm going to show you how this works on a live chart. Okay, so what I've done is I've joined an active chart. It is the weekend when I'm recording this video. So we are looking at BTC USD, and I just want to show you how this feature works. So if you look in the upper left-hand corner, you have a red button and a blue button. A red button means that you want to sell this particular in this case, BTC USD. When you click on the sell button, it's going to give you some parameters here. So for example, do you want to sell one unit, two units? And you, again, you can switch that here, for example, right? Now you have a market order, you have a limit order, and you also have a stop order. So again, you would fill this out depending on what you are looking to do inside of this particular trade. In this case, I'm going to keep it as a market order. Now you also have boxes for take profit, and you also have boxes for stop loss. And what you can do here, for example, is you can either do ticks or you can do price. So let's say, for example, that we want to, since we're going to sell it, we want to take our profit 87. Let's just do a nice number of, let's do 80 ticks higher, 79 ticks higher. Okay. For example, it must be lower than the entry. Okay. So we want to go down, right? Let's see. I'm not even going to look where price is at. So let's say that we want to sell it and we want our take profit to be 25,800. What that's going to tell us is that we are moving down this many ticks. How about our stop loss? Since we're selling, we want a high stop loss. Let's say 25,957. So you would just enter that number here. And again, you would obviously refer to your risk calculators that you might use and what have you. And if you look right here to the right, what this is telling you is that you are risking based on the account size that you currently have that we just established a minute ago, we are only risking 0.20%. So this calculates your risk at the same time, and the risk will change based on the dollar amount. When you are ready for this order to be filled, what you are going to do is you are going to click sell. And what that does is that has opened up this trade for you. You are going to actively see this trade. You can see right now, for example, again, so we were just using an example that we are down $7.12 based on this sell order. So that's the way that you would activate a sell with the parameters of a stop loss and a take profit if you choose to do so in this scenario. Again, so one of the awesome features inside of this paper trading account is that you can see both what you are risking and all of the numbers that you need as a trader before you enter the trade. So now I want to give you an example of a buy order and how you can use paper trading to do that in a live chart. Okay, so now I want to show you an example of a buy order, and I'm on the chart of Litecoin, so LTC with USD, and the exact same types of principle will apply. But in this case, what I want to do is I want to go over to the blue button and I want to click on the blue button. This is for a buy order. Same thing here. You have an option of market, limit, or stop. For this example, I'm just going to use a market order. Okay. And in this scenario, I'm not going to take profit or I'm not going to place a stop loss. I just want to enter the market now, and then I can always go back and change this order. So all I would do here is click buy. And then once you click a buy, you have opened your trade right here. And as you can see right here, we are currently sitting at 2 cents under because the market obviously just retracted down. So that's the example on how you can set a buy order and see how your account is either going higher or lower on the dollar amount inside of this box. Now, let's say that you wanted to include a take profit. As you can see, when you hover over the account here, you have these two boxes right here. You can add a stop loss or you can add a take profit. So let's go ahead and click on take profit, and then it's going to open up this box again. We can click on it and we can decide where we want to take our profit. So let's say that we want to take a profit at 64.18. We would click on 64.18, right? And then that would add it. Once you click on here, you can see now that our profit level has been added. Now let's say that we want to add a stop loss. Same scenario. You can click on stop loss. You can come back over to this box. And let's say that our stop loss is going to be $6,400 or $64. You would click on there. You would click on buy again because it's still in the same trade. And now it has set you up for a parameters. So now this trade includes your initial market execution. You have set a take profit. And you have also set a stop loss. And again, you can currently see here that the market is now trending up, and it'll tell you what actual money you are in profit, which is 9 cents in this case, right? It also tells you that if it hits take profit, you are going to make 18 cents. Okay. And if you hit stop loss, you are going to lose 36 cents. So again, a valuable tool to use, especially right inside of TradingView for you to practice on your daily trades. Okay. So as you can see, a very powerful tool to practice with paper trading. But I want to show you one more way that you can execute exactly what I just showed you using a different method right on your chart as well. Okay, so now I'm on the XRP USD active live chart since it is the weekend. And if you don't want to use these two buttons in the upper left-hand corner, you can also go anywhere on your chart. And what you want to do is you want to go ahead and right-click on your chart. When you do so, you're going to see this tab right here that says trade, and that's going to give you a couple of different options. It's going to give you the opportunity to buy with a limit. You have a stop already set, or you can just create a new order. I particularly would like to create a new order. So you can click on that, and that's going to bring you right back to that box that we just showed you. And again, you would do the exact same thing. If you wanted a market order, or a limit order, you could do that as well. Okay. So again, for this example, we are going to just do a market order and let's go ahead and add a take profit. We'll just do this 5159 back up to that wick just for this example. Okay. We can also do a stop loss and let's just do 5,000 even just for this scenario. So again, just want to show you, you can manually change all these numbers here. And then when you're ready, again, click on buy. And then you can see here that you have all of your parameters that were set inside of the market right in here. So again, just a powerful tool because many traders do not even know that that exists inside of TradingView. So I hope you got some value on this video. If you did, definitely smash the like button and go down to the comments below and let me know if you are using the paper trading inside of TradingView and how's it going for you? Did you use it as a learning tool? And definitely share in our community. And then talking about community, if you have not yet done so, you can see it down scrolling down at the bottom down there. If you want to join our YouTube Diamond members area, it is a limited time offer. We are offering you $4.99 a month for mentorship, for training, for trade ideas. So for $5 a month, the price of a cup of coffee per month, I'm giving you access to some additional information, especially with people who are struggling or new to this. I wanted to make this affordable for everyone and yet hold you accountable for that $5 a month. It's a no-brainer. Go down to the YouTube members area. Go down to the link in the video description if you wanted this video. Click join. We'll see you in the group. I'll put you into our general chat. And then we also have a private message area inside of Telegram for our Diamond members. So I hope you got some value on today's video tutorial on how to do paper trading inside of TradingView.